water towers made for hearts and names. Friday nights made for football games. Falling leaves made for falling in. Front porch steps made for good night kissing. And I was made for you. Yeah, I was made for you. Summer jobs made for spending cash. Second dates made for going fast. And early curfews made for sneaking past. 2 a.m. was made for pissed off dads. And I was made for you. Yeah, I was made for you. Like a ship without a sea, or a song without a melody. I don't know where I'd be or what I'd do, 'cause I was made for you. Smoky bars made for how about a dance. Open roads made for holding hands. And laid back seats made for young love. 2 pink lines made for growing up. And I was made for you. Yeah, I was made for you. Like a ship without a sea, or a song without a melody. I don't know where I'd be or what I'd do. Yeah, I was made for you.
Family and friends, my name is Jo Hurley, and I'm an authorized marriage celebrant. It makes me so happy to be able to welcome you all here today as we celebrate the love of Isaac and Keisha on one of the most important days of their lives. I'm sure you'll all agree with me that Isaac and Keisha make a beautiful couple. Their smiles say it all. Smile. Breathe a smile. The love they share is contagious, and it's impossible not to feel happier in their presence. Isaac and Keisha have known each other for almost half their lives. What started as a friendship in boarding school has grown into a relationship that neither of them can imagine living without. Now, I'm told that before Isaac got down on one knee, he took Keisha out for her very first day of mustering on horseback with the family at spec, just to make sure she could do a full day's work. Arriving home, full of dirt and dust, she must have passed the test, because before she could even change out of her dusty clothes, Isaac was leading her into the darkness to fully appreciate the night sky. One of Keisha's favourite things about spec is the stars. The sky is always beautifully clear and full of stars. Like a dream, Isaac whispered Keisha's name, and she turned around to find him on one knee, asking her to be his wife. She said yes before he even opened up the box to show her the ring. When I asked these two why now is the perfect time to get married, they answered as one. They're best friends who truly know each other and are ready to spend the rest of their lives together, wherever that may lead. I'm sure you'll all agree that their love story is what makes them such a beautiful couple to share life with. As the people closest in the world to Isaac and Keisha, I know you will all share in my joy in being able to celebrate with them today as they make a commitment to spend the rest of their lives together as husband and wife. It's getting real. She's still breathing. It means the world to Isaac and Keisha that all three of Isaac's sisters will be playing an important part in this wedding ceremony today. Firstly, I would love to invite Kathleen to step up and share a special reading called Marry Your Best Friend.
No pressure. Oh, yeah, share some.
All right. Marry your best friend. Really, truly find the strongest, happiest friendship in the person you fall in love with. Someone who speaks highly of you. Someone you can laugh with. The kind of laughs that make your belly ache and your nose snort. The embarrassing, earnest, healing kind of laughs. Life is too short not to love someone who lets you be a fool with them. Make sure that person lets you cry also. Find someone that you want to be there with you through the darkest times. Most importantly, marry the one person who makes passion, love, and madness combine. A love that will never dilute, even when the waters get deep and dark. Marry someone you can't imagine your life without. Marry your best friend.
I am duly authorised by law to solemnise marriage according to law. Before you are joined in marriage, in my presence and in the presence of these witnesses, I am to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship into which you are now about to enter. Marriage, according to law in Australia, is the union of two people to the exclusion of all others voluntarily entered into for life. Isaac, please repeat after me. I call upon the persons here present.
I call upon the persons here present.
To witness that I, Isaac John Bede Curry.
To witness that I, Isaac John Bede Curry.
Take you, Keisha Renee Wilds.
Take you, Keisha Renee Wilds.
To be my lawful wedded wife. To be my lawful wedded wife. I think I said it faster. All right, okay.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
Isaac, do you promise to share your life with Keisha, to love her unconditionally and support her as she chases all her dreams, to share a lifetime of adventures with her all the days of your life?
I do.
Keisha, please repeat after me. I call upon the persons here present.
I call upon the persons here present.
To witness that I, Keisha Renee Wilds.
To witness that I, Keisha Renee Wilds.
Take you, Isaac John Bede Curry.
Take you, Isaac John Bede Curry.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Keisha, do you promise to share your life with Isaac, to love him unconditionally and support him as he chases all his dreams, to bake him sweets and remember he prefers vanilla melting moments, not lemon, all the days of your life?
I do.
We've now come to the moment that is most important to these two, and that is for them to share their vows with each other. I am going to step out of the way and let them speak to each other from the heart.
Keisha, you are my best friend, confidant, safe place, and the person I call home. I love that you support all my goals and aspirations, and I know that together we make a strong and balanced team. We always come out on top, no matter the challenge. I love and trust you fully, and my heart is filled with happiness that today we are committing our lives to love and grow together. Through the journey of our lives together, I promise to always have my arms open to comfort you, to support you, and to encourage you towards your goals and dreams. To be your otter when you need a hand to hold, and do my best to give you horses to care for. Keisha, I admire your big heart and celebrate sharing life and love with you, past, present, and boundlessly into the future.
I think you should give him a clap. That was beautiful.
Isaac, 13 years ago, I made a new friend at boarding school, a cute, brown-haired boy who had more energy than I had ever come across. I had a crush on you then, and I never imagined that I would come to share a life with you and love you as much as I do today. You are my best friend, my strongest supporter, and my absolute love. You have been my sunshine on cloudy days and a double rainbow when the storm has passed. You are kind, caring, annoyingly logical, and the one place I always feel safe. You have given me some of the greatest gifts. You have taught me what it means to live a life true to myself, and you have given me the freedom to discover who I am and who I want to be. You have changed my life, and I am so grateful for you. This life together will be full of unknowns and uncertainties, but I promise you today and always that I will love you fiercely, without hesitation, restriction, or conditions. I will support your goals and help make your dreams a reality. I will tolerate you watching anime and not make fun of you when you watch Gilmore Girls with me and pretend to hate it. I will always be your teammate and friend above all else. I hope you remember my heart will always be home and that so long as we are together, we will always be okay. Isaac, every tough road that we have been on together has been worth it to get here today. Because the love and life that we have built together is and always will be worth fighting for. I love you in a way that words will never be able to reflect. So all I can say is, I choose you. 1,000 times over, in 1,000 different lifetimes, and every day for the rest of our lives. I choose you and I always will.
If you can get double rainbows and Gilmore Girls into vows, I think you're a pretty talented bride. Can I ask for Madeline to come forward now?
My ring. Oh, Keisha's ring, of course. Oh my God. Put it in here. Which way? That way.
Yeah. Please repeat after me. Keisha, I place this ring on your finger.
Keisha, I place this ring on your finger.
With the dream of a never-ending love.
With the dream of a never-ending love.
I hope you'll wear it always.
I hope you'll wear it always.
As a reminder of my love for you.
As a reminder of my love for you.
With this ring, I make you my wife.
With this ring, I make you my wife.
Thanks. Thanks. Ready? Isaac, I place this ring on your finger.
Isaac, I place this ring on your finger.
With the dream of a never-ending love.
With the dream of a never-ending love.
I hope you'll wear it always.
I hope you'll wear it always.
As a reminder of my love for you.
As a reminder of my love for you.
With this ring, I make you my husband.
With this ring, I make you my husband.
Renee, if I can ask you to come and join us. Renee will be sharing the final reading for today, which is called If.
Thank you. If you can always, sorry, if you can always be as close and as happy as today,
yet be secure enough to grow and change along the way. If you can always keep for you alone your lover's man and wife, yet find the time to share your joy with others in your life. If you can be as one and walk through marriage hand in hand, yet still support the goals and dreams that each of you have planned. If you can dare to always go your separate ways, then all the wonder of today, sorry, if you can always dare to go your separate ways together, then all the wonders of today will stay with you forever.
Family and friends, you have witnessed the promises made by Isaac and Keisha that they will shall live together in marriage from this day forward. They have taken their vows, exchanged rings, and pledged their love in our presence. Isaac and Keisha, I am therefore delighted, by virtue of the authority vested in me, to now declare you to be husband and wife. Isaac, you may kiss the bride. If they can only take this cheer squad into their life and every day, every kiss they have from now on. Well, that was amazing. We are going to be signing the marriage certificate now. So if I can ask for you to stay where you are, because we will be coming back shortly. But just give us a chance to make it all legal and then we can come and celebrate together. Thank you.
I was born in a town full of red pine trees. County sign says, follow your dreams. Westbound train makes the whole town shake. Friday night lights decide your fate. I'm born again in a church where the steeple's wide. Preacher preached, Book of John, and my mama cried. Meaning life was in verse 2. Didn't make sense till I found you.
Well, I'd just love to thank everyone for joining us here today in this absolutely stunning open-air chapel to witness the marriage of Isaac and Keisha. I know it means the world to them that you have been a part of this ceremony, and even more important is the love and support you continue to show them as they step back out into the world as husband and wife. In a few short moments, they'll be ringing the bell at the doorway to this beautiful chapel to celebrate their status as Australia's newest married couple, with all of you behind them. So be ready to be shining and celebrating with them together. Isaac and Keisha, I have a final reading for you, which I have taken from a song that will be forever in your hearts. The song Keisha walked down the aisle to, called Made For You. I really hope that every anniversary, you'll remember these words and never forget that love that you have felt on this beautiful day. Like a ship without a sea, or a song without a melody. I don't know where I'd be or what I'd do, because I was made for you. Tiny shoes are made for tiny feet. My two arms are made for where you sleep. The sky was made for the moon and stars. You were made to steal my heart, and I was made for you. Family and friends, please stand. Make some noise and clap and cheer for our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Curry.